Good morning, everyone. My name's David Archer. I'm the CEO of Savannah Resources. We're a AIM-listed company, market cap of about £45 million. I'm conscious that I've only got 10 minutes today, so I'm going to mainly talk to you about what I think to be one of the most exciting new mining projects that's going forward in Europe, and probably the best credentialed lithium project in Europe at the moment. That's me, part of the, and some of the members of our team. Michael McGarty's here in the audience. Martin Steinbild comes from Albemarle. He's a lithium industry professional. Dale Ferguson is leading the operational charge and happens to be in Portugal, where our lithium project is at the moment. Very quickly, market cap 45 million. We have a core and key Middle Eastern shareholder in the WJ Tal Group, one of the largest and wealthiest privately owned family groups in Oman. The sort of the key project that we're focusing in on is our Mina de Barroso mining lease, mine development in the northern part of Portugal. It's a strategic location. It's within the welcoming arms of the EU, and we think it's got outstanding potential to be to sort of lead the charge in terms of developing the upstream part of the lithium value chain here in Europe. And a key feature is it's spodumene mineral. That's the basis of this particular project. Spodumene is the almost exclusively the most internationally traded lithium mineral in the world. So spodumene is what it's all about if you're in the lithium mineral business. I won't say too much about lithium, except two things. One, it's interesting today to see in the Times that the EU is actually taking the British government to the European Court of Justice around air quality problems, particularly here in London, and that's of course all based around diesel vehicles running around this city. So I think that highlights the fact that there really is a real and urgent requirement to sort of shift the vehicle fleet towards electric mobility. And that was particularly highlighted to me a couple of days ago at the Hanover Battery Show. There really is an industrial revolution going on in mainland Europe. It's a really total rebuild and build out of totally differently sort of configured vehicles, and European industry is really getting behind it. And you know, just some of the people I saw there were, you know, Bosch, Siemens, BASF, ThyssenKrupp, VW, Umicore. This is a tectonic change, perhaps not quite apparent here in the UK, but I tell you what, it's happening in Europe, and we want to be part of it. Okay, in terms of our project, it is in the northern part of Portugal, and the principal project that we're working on at the moment is the Mina de Barroso mining lease. It's a granted mining lease for feldspar, quartz and lithium. It's also rather conveniently located to the export port of Porto, 100 kilometres by as the crow flies from our mine. It's an existing bulk port, and it's the second largest port in Portugal. Just moving on, that's the mining lease itself. We acquired this project in May of last year, and we've been hammering it with drilling since then. We've been drilling it non-stop, and we're drilling it today. We've got two drill rigs on site, and we've drilled around about 14,000 metres of holes, about 120 holes in total. And essentially, this is a very large pegmatite system that runs through here. It's a shear zone. The mining lease itself is about 5 square kilometres in area. There are at least 8 to 9 surface apparent pegmatite systems, pegmatite deposits. Unusually, these pegmatites are characterised as being spodumene bearing. That's pretty unusual, and it's pretty good. Puts this in a fantastic position. We've been evaluating three deposits: Noa, Reservatorio, and Grondeo. Whoever named Grondeo was a very insightful person, because it's certainly living up to its name. We've got about 100 drill holes into that deposit at the moment, and we've been focusing in on surface and near-surface pegmatites, and that drilling program is going exceptionally well. We've also proved up a resource here at Reservatorio and a smaller resource here at NOAA. This is a mining lease that is vastly under-evaluated. We're doing the best we can, but there's a lot of volume in there, there's a lot of smoke, and we're certainly finding lots of fire. By way of illustration, this is Grondeo. There's a very extensive, almost flat-lying, slightly dipping tabular ore body here at Grondeo. It's at least 300 to 400 metres wide. It's at least 600 to 700 metres long, and ranges in depth from 10 to about 50 metres in thickness. If mining engineers could ever design an ore body, this is what they'd look to design. This hasn't been designed by a mining engineer, but it enjoys all of the sort of characteristics you'd like to see in a deposit. It's flat lying. It'll enjoy a very very low stripping ratio. It's well graded, and interestingly enough, you can actually sort of see the power lines that actually run over the top of the deposit. It's a great infrastructure setting. It's close to a major road system, and we keep on drilling this, and we keep on finding more mineralisation. This is a deposit and a project that keeps on giving, and I'm really delighted to have this as part of our portfolio. This is a cross section of the mineralisation. As you can see, it's slightly dipping. It'll enjoy a terrifically low stripping ratio. We've got some really good intersections, 30 metres, 50 metres, all 1.3. Certainly, most of these intersections are above 1%. And as you can sort of see, the mineralisation keeps on dipping down here. We'll probably stop the drilling around about 150 metres vertical depth, because we don't particularly want to go underground mining. This is a classic deposit, very much in the same vein as the deposits that you might see in Western Australia. This is what we've proved up to date. That's the shape of the ore body, and as you can see, there's some pretty outstanding lithium intersections there. Really well graded, wide widths, and at surface. So what we've been doing is we started off with 0 tonnes in May of last year. In December of last year, we announced a resource of around about 3 million tonnes. In February, we increased that resource to 9 million tonnes, and in April, we increased that resource to 14 million tonnes. So this is a project that's really growing, and really growing fast, and it's sports a grade of 1.1% lithium, low iron, and about 149,000 tonnes of contained Li2O. We've also defined an exploration target of around about 8 to 12 million tonnes, and that will sort of, provides a little bit of guidance as to where we're shooting for, at least in the short term in terms of total tonnage. As I said, the mining lease is vastly underexplored, and I'd really like to think that we might be able to increase that exploration target over time. What's the next one? Yeah, so the next one is, we have defined a very sort of significant resource there, somewhat akin to, some of the deposits you see in Western Australia, the spodumene deposits there. Plenty of exploration potential. We've been doing all of the metallurgical test work in Australia, which shows that this is a standard spodumene ore, in fact, probably one of the better ones, low in mica, and we can produce a 6% lithium concentrate at greater than 80% recoveries, great existing infrastructure setting, and sort of strategically close to end consumers in Europe, and we've got an export platform out of Porto itself. So we think it's an outstanding project. It very much matches the successful Australian guys, and we're looking to make a development decision in the early part of the first quarter of 2019. We've got a scoping study that's underway at the moment by Hatch. Those results will be out in June, and I think it'll show a very sort of robust project. We're looking at securing partnerships, And we are very modestly sort of capitalised in comparison to our industry peers. I'd commend that you take a serious look at our company. I think we're one of the most exciting projects going forward in Europe at the moment, and there'll be lots more news, and I really look forward to our company playing a material role in the development of a vibrant and robust lithium value chain here in Europe. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.